Well, obviously, I'm totally horrified by what happened. One just needs to look at the video, the images of that bathroom. And it knocks you out. Knocks you out. I still hope my children have not seen that. Those beautiful children I have, making sure that they get the comfort and the sense of their mother and their future, that I protect them from as best I can.
There's a suspect in custody. What's your initial feeling? Was this a person operating as a lone wolf or part of a much grander agenda that we don't see yet?
She is thought of as a lone wolf. As an American, I could easily view that with some skepticism. And actually, along the way, initially my thought, well, why couldn't it be part of a terrorist cell? We've had terrorist cells in a number of places, even in the West. Why couldn't it exist here? There might be a cell involved, certainly. But after seeing the video of how she was captured and what was in her car, she had everything there, all for herself, ready to go. She didn't even care about the blood prints on her steering wheel. She could easily have done this all by herself.
After witnessing such a tragedy, and as an American, and the victims here targeted were Westerners, how do you feel about what has transpired?
How do I feel as an American? I'm still fearful of all of that. However, I've come to feel that it's quite different, and I'm actually starting to believe what my ex-wife was always telling me, that it's safe.
Do you still feel that way after this horrendous tragedy earlier this week?
I'm shocked myself. I am shocked myself that I've come this far, that I've changed based on what I'm seeing here.
I know you were concerned about raising funds, and there was a push by your family in Colorado to give you a hand, but the government has reached out here in Abu Dhabi and made quite a gesture that surprised you.
They're treating me like family now, and they have expressed it almost in precisely those terms. And the children will have nothing to worry about for their education, for their entire education, basically.
We have a suspect in custody. If she's found guilty, do you think justice needs to be served? You know, there's capital punishment here in the UAE.
I can't believe I have the power to pardon. That is shocking to me, and I don't even really want that responsibility. I don't even want to think about it, but we'll have to see how that goes. But if I'm not totally convinced that she's the one, then I probably would pardon. As far as I can tell so far, it seems pretty damning evidence, and she's confessed herself. Iboya, my dear ex-wife, and I do mean that, will not have died in vain.